Welcome back to Inside Texoma. I'm Melissa Kakarika, joined by Dr. Alan Martin and Catherine Phillips from the Friends of the Wichita Falls Public Library. We've been giving you an inside look into the program and into the little free libraries. Right now we're going to talk about how you can help. I know you guys really need volunteers.
Yes, unfortunately we do. Probably all the nonprofits in town would like to have more volunteers, but we've lost a couple of volunteers to death. And I've lost a couple of friends to that same problem. And as a result, we're kind of short-handed. We have several volunteers filling two or three two-hour slots in the bookstore just to keep the bookstore open. But then there's this program with the little free libraries, and we have a partnership with the Nonprofit Management Center, which here in October has the Teens Make a Difference Month. And we're hoping that we can put things together to put out some of these little free libraries this month. But if that doesn't happen, we'll just do it a little later in the year. I'd like to add probably 8 more little free libraries, because I really believe in the concept and the idea that we can put these books out to people. And I think you'd agree that there's got to be more than one neighborhood that would like to have free libraries available.
We have volunteers come from all over Wichita Falls to help with this. Like I said, if you want to go into business, Lighty Cooks help. They put the roof on the first one. We had handyman Dwayne Beasley. He put on the first. He put them together so well. He gets them, you know, the posts in the ground, and it's weather is durable. And we had Joe and Sue Johnson came together, and they built the first little model that we had from Wichita Falls, and a lot of them have been modeled after that. And then we had the neighborhood organization for West Linwood had several volunteers from Shepherd Air Force Base come out to put together about 10, 12 of them. So we have some more models around, but we've had a lot of volunteer support for this. So if you're handy, if you like to build little things, you know, just come on out and build a little free library.
So you can help with both the library and manning the bookstore.
Yes.
Pretty much.
Yes,
anything.
And little free libraries are the sort of thing that once they're in place, it's just a matter of keeping an eye on them and keeping them stocked. And I'm happy to say that the Wichita Falls Independent School District has this year given the Friends of the Library 155 cartons of books withdrawn from schools, Alamo and one I never knew about, which is Hershey Junior High. We see some books from there. And from, of course, the area high schools and junior highs. With all the mergers and so on, there have been duplicates. And of course, the older books get withdrawn and replaced with newer ones. And we also get libraries, the library books that are withdrawn from circulation. And most of us agree that, you know, the taxpayers paid for those books. Let's put them back into the hands of the taxpayers. And the little free library is one way to do that, and then the Friends of the Library is another. We make books available free of charge to church libraries and church pastors, because we have so many of them, and a lot of them look like they've never been read. But we also make books available to homeschoolers. The ones I've talked to are usually on a fairly tight budget, and they need the help to get extra books available for their children to use in their curriculum. And, of course, the little free libraries are a place where a lot of books go. We want people to come pick out what they want. We don't want to give something they don't want, and we, above all, don't want books going into the landfill. They can be chewed up and turned into compost and have a second life or a third life or a fourth life, however you want to look at it, as compost. And that way, they don't go into the landfill. And that's a thing that we also think about our children and our grandchildren.
Of course. And now on the topic of donations, you're always looking for donations as well, too. If you have some books lying around, maybe from college, maybe from when the kids were little that aren't going to be in use anymore, I mean, how would somebody donate to you guys?
Okay, they call the library at 767-0868. The bookstore is extension 248, but they can just take them into the library. Even if the bookstore is closed, the library will accept the books. And they'll put them on a cart for us to take up to storage or to remove to the warehouse, depending upon what they are and how much space we have available. Dr. Cuevas, who was our secretary and my good friend from Midwestern, passed away in June. But before she passed away, she gave us a Dodge cargo van, gave it to the Friends of the Library to use. So we have the means to go out and pick up books. We can pack them. We have boxes. We have some volunteer help that's willing to do that. We'll go out and we'll pick up the books. We'll we can give you a receipt if you itemize your taxes, but most people don't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. So however you want to handle it, we make memorial gifts available. Donations to the Friends of the Library in memory of somebody are appropriately handled accordingly. And the thing that we are most proud of is when we see a child sitting in the library just reading a book, or anywhere, just sitting reading a book, that's something special. As you mentioned, in these days where all the electronic media is, you think about a book, doesn't need batteries, it has no commercials, and it can be a part of your own personal private library. You keep it forever.
I imagine that's why you take part in it. I mean, just talk a little bit about what you're getting out of it.
Yeah, you know, and we're here in Wichita Falls, but I get to travel to Garden City, Kansas quite often now, and their library there has beautiful outdoor play area and learning area for the kids. And there are two little free libraries in that area, right on the library property. So if our library was thinking about it, you know, maybe they could have some little free libraries there too. I mean, they're versatile. They can go anywhere in town. They're user friendly. And the cool thing is, school's not just a school. The whole world is a school. So why don't we make literacy just accessible for our kids?
Right, and as Hillary Clinton pointed out, it takes a village to raise a child.
You better believe it.
And that's where where the volunteers can come in. If a volunteer wants to work just on little free libraries, that's fine with us. We have two volunteers that are primarily responsible, actually now three volunteers responsible for our warehouse. We have a married couple that takes care of the storeroom, which is upstairs in the library. And we have a family that is responsible for getting volunteers and all the things together for the Dr. Seuss birthday party. So if you have a special interest, give us a call. We'll find some way to make it happen.
Absolutely. We want to thank you guys so much for being here, for sharing your work, and just a great message about literacy.
Okay.
Thank you so much. We certainly hope everybody reaches out to the Friends of the Library, you know, volunteers, donations, or even just help with the little free libraries, with the book sales, anything you can do, I'm sure it'd be very appreciated. Thank you for tuning into Inside TechSoma.